Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. You are welcome to online business studies. Last lesson, we discussed on the business organization. And we've managed to discuss on sole proprietorship, partnership, cooperative society, and that of limited liability company. This very week, inshallah, we are going to move on to another topic, which is on consumer and that of a society. So this week's topic is on consumer and society. Once again, this week's topic is based on the consumer and that of a society. The first thing that should come into your mind is the meaning of consumer. What is consumer, or who is a consumer? A consumer is a person that buy goods in units from the retailer. Consumer is a person that buy goods in units from the retailer. Consumer, from that very definition, you realize that a consumer is a person that decided to have certain products for his own personal use. He will buy that very product and he will use it for his own interest. In the world today, all the people, once again, all the people in the art service are potential consumers. Because one way or the other, we are going to buy, and whatever we buy, we are going to use it for our own personal interest. And that's the reason why we concluded that a consumer is the final user of a particular goods. So consumer, others' name, could be said to be final user. Then the next thing is to define where consumer operates, and that leads us to the other one, which is market. What is a market? A market is a place where the buyer and the seller meet to interact. A place where the buyer and the seller meet to interact. So a potential buyer is now a consumer. A potential buyer is now a consumer. So a consumer buys. When he buys from a particular seller. So the interaction between the consumer and that of a seller is based on where they meet. Where they meet is referred to as a market. So a market is a place where the consumer and that of a seller meet to buy and to sell. So the other one that needs urgent explanation is where, or the location where the consumer and that of market sighted. And that leads us to the next subtopic, which is a society. A society is a particular community that harbor both the consumer, the market, even the manufacturer of a particular goods and that of the government. Once again, I said, society could be defined as a particular community that harbor both the consumer, the manufacturer, the market, and that of the government at a particular time. So society at large is a particular location where the consumer, then that of the market where the consumer buy, then the manufacturer, the person that, you know, produce that very product, and the government that gave them the approval. So that is what society is. Now, having known the definition for the consumer, the society, and that of the so-called society, what are the need for consumer education? What are the need? Why do we need that consumers should be educated? Consumers need to be educated as a result of the following. The first one is that when the consumer is being educated, it develops the consumer's awareness between the real and that of the likelihood of that very commodity that he is to buy. Once again, I said it develops the awareness of, you know, that particular goods that a consumer is willing to buy. The reason why he is willing to buy it, if there is real enlightenment on that very particular product, definitely the consumer will not miss buy. The other point is that it allows the consumer for prudent spending. When a particular consumer realizes what he or she is willing to buy and the purpose of buying it, definitely he has to be prudent. Prudent in this sense means that he has to, you know, buy according to what is in or our purse. He will not overspend. By not overspending, it means you are prudent. So consumer education allow a particular consumer to be prudent. It allow that very particular consumer to be prudent. The third one is that it allows consumer to be selective in obtaining certain goods. Whenever a consumer is about to buy, that very consumer needs to buy what he or she is supposed to have at that very point in time. So he has to be selective, because in midst of many products, he has to select the best. So if not because of that education he or she has acquired as required by the need for consumer education, you will not be able to do such a thing. So to be selective is one of the advantages of consumer education. Another point is that it ensures better management of financial resources, ensuring that whatever a consumer has impulse, He has to manage, and he has to use the little amount of money within him or her to acquire what is necessary at that point in time. The fifth one is that it prevents consumers from falling victim to the fake product When a consumer have knowledge about certain product, that is consumer education. By the time he acquired that skill, he acquired that very knowledge, a particular consumer will not be falling victim to buy fake product, because he will be able to check properly, on the type of goods that he or she need and willing to buy. The sixth one, consumer education enlighten consumer of their rights. Everybody has his or own rights. Producer has their rights. Retailer has their own rights. Wholesaler has their own rights. Likewise, consumer also have their own rights. By the time a consumer is enlightened as regard particular production, then he or she will be able to know what to do at the right time. The last one here is that it helps the consumer to protect from deceptive advertisement. We have various adverts on the radio, on the television, even inside the daily newspaper. We have various deceptive advertisement, and when this advert is being published to the member of the public, even by broadcasting or by means of daily newspaper, an enlightened consumer will not fall victim to be deceived by the rate of advertising. You'll be able to look very well, as you know that you look before you leap. So these are the reasons why consumer need to be educated. Then the other subtopic here is the importance of consumer education in our lives. As I said earlier, we are all potential buyers. As you are buyer, then you are consumer. You are consuming certain things daily. Definitely, you are consumer. Then when you are not consumer, it means you are buying. Somebody that buy is referred to as buyer. At the same time, it is going to be a potential consumer. Then the importance of consumer education on our daily life is that, number one, it helps us, that is consumer, to make good purchase. When you are educated on certain product that needs to be used by you, there is no way you will be able to buy the right thing. And not buy that right thing, but to buy it at the appropriate time when that good is needed. So consumer education has assisted many consumers today to have good purchase. Secondly, it helps consumers to decide on what to buy. Consumer education has assisted many of us to decide on what to buy. Why do I buy this? Do I need this thing now? Those are the questions that will come into your mind before you buy, because you have been educated on that very issue before you go to the market to have that very purchase. So it allows a consumer to decide on what to buy. The third one is that the consumer education also has allowed us to know what to buy. Having know what to buy, then there is need for us to know how to buy it. There is difference between what and how. you've known what to buy, then how do I meet up to buy? So it allows us to think deeply where to make our purchase. Then the fourth one is that it compels the producer to be accountable of their product. We have various producers in the world. We have various producers in the society. The producer are being checked because they realize that consumers have been educated on the product they want to sell. So in this case, it has compelled that very producer to produce the better thing and not to produce fake product to the members of the public. Then the fifth one is that it makes the producer to be more responsible of what to produce. It allows a particular producer to think before laying their hands on certain production, because the producer might have realized that the consumer have been educated on the product they are about to produce and to supply to the members of the public. So you now realize that consumer education is very, very essential and is very, very important in our daily life. It has assisted a lot. It has assisted even as we are developing, because we are in a developed country now. Those developed country, what they have achieved, we developing country too, we've achieved it, because we have little education on the product being brought to us. So this now leads us to the last topic. That is the last topic on this consumer education, and that is the consequences of lack of consumer education. What are the consequences of not being educated on certain products that you are about to buy? What are the consequences? When we say consequences, we mean the problem facing by a particular consumer for not having real sense of what he or she wants to buy at a particular time. So the first one is that a particular consumer that fails to be educated on the type of product he or she willing to buy at a particular time chooses to buy wrong product. And as you buy wrong product, it will definitely affect your life. Definitely it will affect your life. Then the second one is that it leads to wasteful spending. Someone that lack consumer education will buy what is not even necessary at a particular time. He will buy it. And by the time he buy, in getting home, he realize that what he has buy is waste. It means that he has been able to waste the little resources with him or her at that very point in time. The third one, which is very, very serious in the community today or in our society today, for lacking of not having consumer education, is that of the death of many consumers in the society. We have various consumers that wrongly buy certain products because they don't have knowledge about that very product. By that day, consuming this very product, it may lead to the end of their life. Yes, especially on drugs, even on the food taken, the canned food, the expired one. When you are not educated enough, you are tend to, you know, eat what can cause havoc to your life. So that is one of the greatest mistakes here. A consumer need to have consumer education. Then the last but not the least is that the consumer may not be able to maximize the required knowledge that he or she needed in buying certain goods and services. And by the time this happens, it is a great problem for that very consumer at that very point in time. And when we say consumer, a father at home may be a consumer. A mother at home may be a consumer. Buy certain products in the market and bring it in into that very family. And all the family member now took this very product. May Allah forbid bad things. By the time all these family members taste it, and they taste wrong product, it will lead to many things. It will lead to havoc. And it might even lead to death. Meaning that they have to be very, very careful in taking the chances of buying the right thing. And for you to buy the right thing, it means you need to be educated on what you're supposed to buy. Conclusively, I want to draw back to the meaning of this very topic one by one. I said, what is consumer? A consumer, I define it as a person that ends the life of a particular product at a point in time. And I said, every member of the society in today's world are potential consumer. The second one is that of the market. I define market for you as a place where the buyer and the seller interact. That is where they meet to exchange money for goods. That is market. Then the last one, and that's the very topic, is the society. I define society for you as a location that harbor both the consumer, the market, the government, and the lines. So that is a definition for the society. A place or a particular point that harbor both the government, the consumer, and the society. Then the last one is that of the need for consumer education, the importance of consumer education, and the consequences. On the need for consumer education, I told you that it allows consumer to be selective whenever they want to buy. It allows prudent spending. It allows consumers to be, you know, mindful of whatever they want to buy. And it makes the producer, you know, to be more responsible of what they produce to the society. Then lastly, it's on the consequences of that very particular consumer education. I said it leads to death. When you buy fake goods and you take fake goods, then by taking it, it can lead to death. Then it allow people to spend more than what they have. Those are the consequences of not being educated of what you want to buy. Inshallah, this is where I will draw the curtain on this very topic. Inshallah, we are going to continue from there next lesson. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.